Okay, guys, so then let's review the renders. I got under my images folder, I got all the render layers with the associated folders with the render passes. Now, if I go back to Maya and show you this one more time, in the file output, whenever you associate a name like, let's say, a render layer, and you put a slash, then this becomes a folder. And then if you keep adding slashes, these are folders. So we're creating a folder system. And then after the slash here, all this is a name. So shot one is the scene, specific scene with its associated render layer and its associated render pass. Make sure it's a TIFF and make sure it's named dot extension. I forgot to do that, and I had to re-render and have the TIFF and the dot extension so it will be readable from After Effects. If I go to After Effects, let me just bring them back again so I can show you. So I have a comp. Composition settings. I have a comp for I'm not doing any image sequence, but you know, for the sake of it, I'm gonna put 24 frames per second. I'm probably sure you have to do the same, because we have shot in 24 frames per second our footage from the Blackmagic camera. Now I'm gonna go and just double click on this area and go to my images. Let's make sure it's under passes. Yeah, and select all these passes. And everything is here. So if I go and review, let's say the AO, now I have like, and let me fit. So this is my, it's a beautiful frame. So we have everything actually under each layer, under each folder, organized. So I need to go to my composition, and I think we have to start with the, first of all, the background image, which I need to bring from like my source images. Here's the background image. I'm just gonna drop it into After Effects, and I think it's not measured correctly. It's just a reference image. I'm gonna throw it in there. It's not sized correctly, so I'm gonna go ahead and fit to comp. I'm gonna lock that. So now I'm gonna bring in, the first thing we need to bring is the diffuse with no shadow. If I bring that in here and I do difference, I get a diffuse. But now I just realized that I had I shot this, I actually rendered this with the floor because it was in the master layer. So that's not a problem. We are going to go back to Maya and just do only one render layer that is different from, so I'm gonna make sure that these are not, they're not gonna render. I'm gonna make sure these are locked, create another one, and bring again everything in. So add selected object. So what we need here is, like, basically we want the floor, because the floor is gonna drop some light, and we might not need anything else. We just have we have to make sure that this is not visible. We have to make sure that the IBL is not visible, and we have to make sure that the floor is not visible. And let's, if I go ahead and do a render, batch render, all these are not, it's only going to add this, which is going to be this is going to be our diffuse. So I'm going to do a render pass, batch render, and let's go and look at our scenes here. Notice that it's starting to only render what we need, so the diffuse. So you don't have to go through the whole process again. So anything you don't want to render, just lock it. There's a little X sign there that prevents it from rendering. So I'm gonna go ahead and bring this in. This is the diffuse. Get that diffuse and bring it in here. And let's fit this. So notice that the diffuse that is very white, it's very bleached out. These are 32. Let's change this to 32. 32 bits, because we made the frame buffer in Maya, which let me show you right now. It's a float RGBA 32-bit image. There's a lot of information, more than the 8-bit images, and I have to go in the interpret footage main to the color management and turn this off. So at least we get the color information according to my. So now we have this really initial image. Let's drop the shadow. If we go to our master layer, I have a raw shadow. Select the raw shadow and drop it in here. Now select that raw shadow and do a frame blending and do a difference. So you can see the shadow is in there now. Now if you want to add more shadows, that's why I have the other, I added a separate shadow master layer. Remember when we had like the floor as a surface, as a use background material. So this needs to go underneath the master beauty. And this is really dark. And that we need to definitely pull the opacity down. So this is not, you know, if you don't need that, you can actually, you know, depending on this shadow here, you're gonna have to sort of blend these together. So let's go full resolution so we can see. So this is so now these are like really, they're floating. So the problem is that we need more. We need to add the AO. We also have direct irradiance. This one, we'll see if we need it, but this is more. It has to do with all the color passes. So this actually, let me leave this out for a second. I'm gonna come back to that. Let's go and finish with the AO. Now this one, the blending should be a multiply filter. So I get the multiply filter. And it's too intense right now. I need to go and drop the opacity down. Something like that. So that looks pretty good. Of course, we're still. So you can see that all these are just dropped over the background, which now we're really good. We need the final one would be. Let me get rid of the irradiance. I don't think you guys need to do that. I think it already looks good. The only thing we need to do is to add the indirect. Here's the indirect illumination on its own. And let's drop this over here. And we need to add that. Now, adding that is going to blast this image. Plus, it takes over the AO, so I'm going to drop it underneath the AO and definitely take the opacity down. So this is a cool thing because you can actually, like, you can add a little bit of light to your scene if needed. So that's like a nice feature. That's the indirect. So the indirect adds a little bit of more light. Now everything looks super sharp. And I notice that I think everything is fine except the fact that it's super, super sharp. That's why we have the depth pass. So I'm going to save this as test passes 4. And I'm going to take the composition and drop it into another comp, and in this comp here, I'm going to do a final depth pass. The depth pass is this image that we created. It's a luminance depth image. It's not, those objects are really small, and we don't have enough space. They're so close together, so it's not It's not the best luminance depth that I've ever, I mean, I've had, you know, I've had better ones before, but depends on the sort of assembly of this of the scene. But this goes underneath, and then we need to drop on this comp, this final comp, we need to drop a camera lens blur. So camera lens blur. Hexagon is a good one, and you notice now that it's a lot generally unfocused, so you have to kind of pull your just so I'm not gonna explain many things here because we don't have the time, so we just need to go and add the depth map pass inside that layer. So now the information is there, we just need to like play with the focus distance. So I'm gonna pull this closer. So the more, see, I'm like focusing. I'm gonna go probably like something like this, since this is the where the area that we're focusing on. And and that should be it. This is like the final image. Of course, we are going to do all this compositing. And then after that, we're going to use a flat image. This is only a reference image, so we're not going to use that. We're definitely doing all the blur, and then underneath here, we're going to use another image that is going to be our, I can go, let's see, I can bring in this image again. That's here, sorry. So basically, in this one, we would have to do the composite the actual footage for. But for now, we're using this as a reference to see how they how the shadows are working. So this is pretty much it. You guys are going to be just rendering all these out. So I don't think you need, since I put it all together, I don't think we need the diffuse and no shadow. We don't need this. Let's forget the irradiance for this project. Everything else is good. Indirect, the indirect, again, in the master layer, we don't need it because we created our own indirect. And so we use a depth pass, separate layer, a diffuse pass for only the objects that are floating. And indirect, I mean inclusion, the master beauty is always gonna render. And the shadow raw. This is the master beauty. Again, this looks weird because we have to go to over here and make sure that this is off. So that's kind of like a reference image for what we get here. So that should be enough for us to complete this project.